So we have some new Bleach and Burn the Witch info given to us, and I say Bleach info with a little bit of a pinch of salt, but we'll get into that very shortly because I'll give you somewhat of a exclusive, so to say. So if you like this channel, hit that like and subscribe, and I haven't done a video in ages, so that just felt really rusty to say, but let's get into it, shall we? Now, of course, if you guys haven't been watching the live stream or Club B Inside, Club B Inside, which is Kubo's fan club, which they've done a new kind of web series type thing where they do one every few months, it seems. Of course, there's going to be another one because at the end of the live stream, it said, see you next time, which is obviously, of course, because there's still more Bleach news to come in the future, obviously with Core 3 and 4. Now, of course, we're going to have some Jump Festa news as well, but for this stream in particular, it was always going to be very focused on Burn the Witch. Of course, what we had some leaked images the other week of the new Burn the Witch key visual, which was really cool to see in high quality. Nini, Noelle looking perfect as per usual, Balgo looking goofy, and of course, the dragon in the background. And of course, we've also had, I think during Bleach's Core 2 run, we also had the Burn the Witch PV, which was very short and very, you know, a quick little teaser. But in today's episode of the live stream, we actually got a longer PV with more scenes introduced. And of course, as I said in that video that I did on Burn the Witch 0.8, it seems that we're going to get a lot more new scenes that weren't from the manga. And of course, things are going to be tweaked around here and there because, again, things that was in Chapter 0, or 0.8 as we call it now, things that was in Chapter 0 were incorporated in the Burn the Witch 3 episode, such as the West Branch of the Soul Society. Obviously, that probably won't be in this episode because it was already in like episode 3, so I digress. It looks great. Is there an animation increase? I think so. It's either that or the storyboarding is extremely creative, to which I will say, like, obviously seeing the medallion in like Nini's eyes and just seeing the whole fluidity, just, it's Studio Colorido, and again, they've only got like one episode to play with, so it should be like fluid, right? Like, their scheduling and production should be extremely like thankful if all they've had to do is work on a 30 minute episode. I wonder if it's going to be longer than 30 minutes. Probably not. I'm asking for more than maybe I can chew, but I do believe like the one shot was like 60 pages. So there was, you know, that's probably a good 40 minutes to maybe an hour, potentially, if they really want to add more scenes as well. It might be quite the nice little treat. Of course, as well, we had the voice actor for the guy that I forgot his name that turned into a dragon. But still, it was also, again, nice to see that dragon in the PV. And we get to see a little bit of that fight within this PV as well. So it was really nice to see. And I just hope there's that manga panel where, like, that dragon kind of... Actually, speaking of, was it a different dragon? I know, like, obviously we had black dragons, but, like, I'm pretty sure this dragon was quite droopy. And then, like, it was able to, like, disconfigure itself. And then, like, that's how, like, Nini broke her arm. So, are we getting, like... I'm gonna have to read the chapter again. But if my memory is serving me correctly, we could have two dragons. Or the dragon might be changed completely. I don't know. I'm waffling nonsense. Point is, Burn the Witch, it's Burn the Witch season. It's going to be very exciting. We have got an announcement date, which is going to be on the 29th of December. So just in time for the new year. It's going to coincide with the other three episodes of Burn the Witch, which will be on TV. So we're going to get like 2 hours of Burn the Witch on TV. I'm there. I'm going to be peeping it. It's going to be very exciting. And I'm going to be interested to see how they're going to like edit it all together. And I'm just kind of wondering to myself as well, is one, I hope they do a movie release, because I feel like that would be a cool like movie experience. But also, does that mean that they're gonna re-release a Blu-ray with the extra episode in and make me rinse my money yet again? But yes, nothing too extraordinary, so to say. We got a PV and we got a key visual and we got the information of when it's going to come out. It's fantastic, it's exciting, I'm there, I'm all for it. Oh, and of course, how could I forget to mention as well that Nil is back for the opening slash ending, whatever you want to classify the theme song to be. But since as it was the ending for like the past three episodes of Burn the Witch, I would imagine that this is going to be an ending song as well. I hope that when they do the rebroadcasting, they do like a little bit of a miss and match with like the ending songs, and they do a bit more like make them varied a little bit. But we've got a new Nil song called Prove. And yeah, I'm really glad that Nil's back, actually, to be honest with you. It's a bit of a shame that the Nini voice actor didn't actually get to do like a song, considering like Kubo didn't know that she could sing when Burn the Witch was actually happening. So I thought that would have been a great opportunity to have Nini's voice actor like kind of do a song. But to bring Nil back, strong voice, beautiful voice at that. So I'm very happy with the decision to bring Neil back into 0.8. Then, of course, we get onto the Bleach side of things, which was unfortunately just a club outside chill and showing some new figures that they're going to be bringing out, such as like Figure Art and Precious Gem, which you will see on screen. Cool figures. I did like the Sashiro and the Ichigo. That looked really cool. But in regards to your questions about whether there's going to be like the Hell Arc or any new information on Core 3, no, because you will have to wait until Jump Festa, because I can tell you that there is obviously, I mean, it's like saying, you know, water's wet, right? Or ice melts. It's because it's obvious. But we are going to be getting some more Bleach anime info at Jump Festa, especially in regards to like Core 3. So I don't really know what to tell you other than that. It was never going to be a Bleach specific live stream. It was always Burn the Witch. But in terms of like, I'm glad that currently there's been no date in regards to Bleach Core 3, because it gives me a little bit of hope that the longer that they postpone giving us a date release, the chances are the higher the production time, and the longer that it takes, the better. I'm all for it. So I'm expecting a release date at Jump Festa. I'm hoping it's going to be the last season of the year. So hopefully like fall or something like that. And then we have close to like a year of like production. And I think it needs it really badly. So I'm going to end it off there. I haven't done a video in a long time. So tell me what you guys think, of course, in the comment section down below. And of course, with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers. Let you guys, of course, have this fine day. Been handsome as always, people. Peace out.